Hello guys, and welcome to a new Still Division video today by me, Vulcan. Today I have for you a 4 versus 4 on Colleville, and in this one I'm going to be playing with the 16th Luftwaffe. On the Allied side today we have Spax using the 7th Armoured, Maximilian on the 3rd Armoured, Commander Data on the Guards Armoured, Theoman 222 on the 2nd Infantry. On the Axis side I'm of course using the 16th Luftwaffe, Tynerick's using the 9th Panzer, Sora's using the Festung Gross Paris, and Mickeey is using the 21st Panzer. So this was a really fun game where Mickeey sort of worked with me to gain an advantage, and then we sort of had a really epic late game, and it was really, really fun to not only watch but to play. So you guys have that to look forward to. In the meantime, let's see where we're going. We're going to be heading into this town, and these are the sorts of units that I'm bringing up. So it's a bunch of Luftwaffe Pioneers alongside Luftwaffe Jaeger with the Command Infantry in there. I've also decided to bring in an 88 early and a couple of Panzerstrecks to join that. Furthermore, I do have a Flak Panzer Brenn and this Mortar. Then I'm going to be supported by Mickey's Brumbeer, and I've also got another unit of Luftwaffe Jaeger just to hold the mid. But the idea really was to kind of try and push through and just control this town. Play quite defensively because I'm not a huge fan of the 16th Luftwaffe. I don't feel like they can push very well at the moment. So I decided to just kind of try and take the town and then go defensive. That was really the plan from the beginning. And it did kind of go quite well, but you'll see in the late game just how crazy it got. Now, one thing I do want to say is that thanks to bets, I think this game was set up with the Sodbot on my Discord. And if you guys haven't already, make sure that you do join my Discord. There is a link in the description. There's a thing called Sodbot on it. It's the same as on the Steel Division League if you guys are on that Discord as well. It's developed by Betts at the moment, and Val has given him a hand with it in the past. But basically, you can use commands to get divisions and a map for like random 4v4s or 3v3s or all the different game modes. And in this one, we did random 4v4. It gave us Colleville with all of these divisions. So that's basically how we sorted out the game. But let me speed it up, and we will get this underway. And you guys can watch what happens. It was a pretty damn fun game, and I had a lot of fun on stream this weekend. If you guys do want to come and watch my streams in the future, they are at 8 p.m. BST on Saturdays and Sundays. Sometimes I don't stream on the Saturday, but generally I let people know in advance if that's going to be the case on my community tab on YouTube. So if you go onto my YouTube page, there is a community tab where I have like sort of announcements that I put out if needed. But we're going to jump to my perspective now, and we'll see how this goes. Do have a unit on this right side here as well. That's just going to be holding the line at this this tree line here. But my infantry is spreading out. I did forget to unload my, or actually use my mortar, even though I unloaded it early. But thankfully, my opponent did bring in the smoke. I believe I'm up against Theoman in this town, which is the 2nd Infantry. Maximilian going to be trying to push up a unit of infantry to the mid. But yeah, we're going to have to deal with some pretty high veterancy infantry early on. Luftwaffe Pioneers should be able to do a decent job with that. They are, of course, Ranger Assault, 6-man squads. The Pioneers with their grenades generally should do the job. And in this case, well, unfortunately they missed due to Theoman microing backwards. But Mickeey did bring in a Raketenwerfer with me, or a Villefachwerfer even, and he does have the Brumbeer on the way. So this sort of artillery support was really, really nice. I've of course got my own mortar here trying to do the similar thing, but the idea really is just to pin down enemy infantry ahead of me and then just try and continue to advance onto it. So here I'm just chasing down the Ranger Assaults, trying to get as far forward as I can. I do bump into the M4DD, just going to jump out of that building as I don't want that to be the case. And now my 88 from the left is getting involved. So I decided to place my 88 just here because it's perfect 1,200 meter range towards this town and sort of the road here. So if it just starts to move forwards and this M4 starts to retreat, then it does leave me in a very good position to try and take that out. Grimbert takes a shot in the face. My Luftwaffe Jäger are currently trying to jump up and just get into range with the Faustpatron. They would be jumping up quicker, but that's as fast as they can do it. There is a limit on sort of house jumping. And well, Theoman coming in with the smoke there actually helps me out get this Luftwaffe Jäger closer and closer. Eventually I'm going to be right on top of that M4, but then there are some rifles in the way. Range Marauders do go down. We see the Luftwaffe Jäger. Can they get the Faustpatron shot off? No, they can't. Get pinned down, they get surrendered. Unfortunate. 259 also goes down. Panzerschreck just going to be aiming at the rifles. Now I have the Flak 88 on an attack move order. I want that to get a little bit closer so that we can get a shot into the M4 possibly in the future. So at the moment, haven't really brought in too many reinforcements, but they are on the way. We've got Flak Panzer Bren coming in. There's also the FK 288. Those FKs, they actually turned out to be really, really useful throughout this game, not necessarily as AT, but as artillery, which is their primary purpose anyway. They're again just using the Pioneers to drop a grenade, micro out the way, and job well done. I did take my grenade to the face there from Theoman's infantry, but Theoman's infantry getting very low on in numbers now, and I do manage to take out two squads with the Luftwaffe Pioneer, which is absolutely perfect. Panzerstreck is trying to jump up, does not want to get killed off by the M4, but the M4 ends up going down to the 88. Really nice shot comes in from the left there, gets the job done. Brimbiar manages to clean up the mortar on that left side. So this 88 positioning's done me a lot of favours so far. But those Ranger Marauders actually end up killing one of my infantry squads before they unload, which is not something you want to see very often, but we are making ground here thanks to Mickey's help with this Brimbiar. He is finding shots onto these 60mm mortars, and this 88 on the left has been doing a lot of favours as well, cleaning up a GMC there before the infantry unloaded, and you can see that that has gone down to 2 health. Yeah, more units on the way. The Luftwaffe, second Luftwaffe on the way for Mickey. And, well, I believe Mickey was just kind of hanging out on this right side very defensively, whilst helping me kind of push through this town, and so far so good. He does manage to take out an infantry before it unloads there with the Brimbiar. M1 gun is taking shots at the 222, trying to clean that up with the 88. Of course, I'm also going to be unloading the FK-288 that can attack the M1 gun as well quite successfully due to its 9 HE. The 222 does go down. FK is going to help out though, get the direct shot onto the M1 gun. 88 finishes the job. Unfortunate that he had to lose the 222, but there we go. FK 288 now going to try and kill off the M3 half tracker. Could have moved the Luftwaffe Jäger forwards to find that kill, but the FK should be able to do the job. It does have the 1,200-meter range on its AP, on its AP shells, so should be enough to eventually get this kill. Nice field effect there. There does force back some of the infantry of Theoman. Eventually take out that half track on the left with the help of the 88. The 88 was just doing so much work early on because it seemed as though Theoman didn't have the artillery he needed to range onto that. Like these 60mm mortars, they only have, I think, 900m range. And obviously that's not enough to get the job done against an 88 that's like over 1,200m range away. So we have now killed off both of those Ranger mortars, and killing artillery was really one of the themes in this game. And where I had to kind of keep on top of the infantry that Theoman was presenting, otherwise I would be in trouble. But Range Marauders there, going to come under fire from the Flak Panzer Bren, rip them to shreds. These Flak Panzer Brens are really, really good at taking out infantry, so I was trying to make use of that throughout the game to pick them off where I could without being in line of sight of these M4s. These M4s can actually be a big problem against the Luftwaffe. If my 88 hadn't taken out the M4 in the town, I would have had to rely on Panzerstrecks. And Panzerstrecks are only really useful in these town areas, but if the M4s are kept at a distance, then they can really do a lot of damage without you being able to do much about it. Like, I can maybe use a FK-288, since it does have 1,200 meter range. As the M4 gets closer, the AP value of the FK goes up, and therefore at like the 1,000 meter range, you're looking at 11 AP versus 10 armor. But it's pretty unlikely with the amount of shots that you have that that won't happen. Like, you won't get like a decent penetration in time, because you've only got like 11 shots left now on this FK, for example. Unfortunately here, Brumbear shows side armor as Mickeey tries to retreat it, and unfortunately dies. I did give a defense beacon there to sort of notify Mickeey, but Mickey's asking for supply back here. I don't think I brought it in for a little while. And just kind of trying to keep up with the infantry that I was losing, and just getting more reinforcements in to sort of control the front line. But FK does get forced back by this M4. Now we've got some artillery coming in onto my 88. Pioneers on the left, trying to make some ground against some ranger supports, but of course ranger supports out of that range are king due to their 30 cals. So yeah, more Panzerstrecks on the way, just trying to make a really good defensive position. Panzerstrecks are the only real answer that I have to an M4, which is why they're coming in. And I've also got some pioneers there to help out. Unfortunately, my fusiliers do show themselves briefly, which are probably not the best idea against this M4. Panzerstreck going to be looking for the kill onto the duck there. Does find the duck kill, but the rifle's unloaded just in time. So just set up quite defensively now. One of my Luftwaffe Panzerstrecks does go down. Luftwaffe Pioneers just about managed to get into the building there before getting pinned. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in some off-map. The idea of the off-map is to find and kill their artillery, because I don't want my 88s to die unnecessarily, and I can see that there is something here hitting my 88. So that's what I'm going to be trying to focus on with my Storch, and of course drop off-map onto that because of it. And whilst I can see the salient, I'm just going to be driving a infantry squad into that. Of course the M4 could turn and start to fire at that, so I've got to be a little bit careful. But either way, just going to continue into the gap there. So here comes the Storch. Does provide that good recon. It does have the very high optics. There we go, Luftwaffe Fusiliers dropping off and getting into that position will provide me a lot of decent recon information in the future. Black Panzerbrenn now going to sneak around this tree line and try and help out with these Ranger assaults as well. But as you can see, this infantry is having a hard time trying to make ground. 88's been doing a great job. FK-288's been doing alright. Just trying to wait for the opportunity here to move this up and get that strike in. I believe I probably just forgot about it, but either way, eventually I do get around to using it for the off-map and rather than just recon. But yeah, FK-288 alongside the Flak Panzerbrenn going to do a lot of damage to some of those Ranger assaults. They try and push forwards. I should have had these Luftwaffe Pioneers on return fire ideally, because they want to be using their grenades, not their machine guns. The machine gun that they do have is pretty powerful though. The MG-15 does have 4 HE, so that is something. But there we go, barrage now coming down onto Theoman's mortar. Can also see that there is a xylophone on the way. I'm going to have to be wary about that in the future. But if I can take out this mortar, then the 88 should survive and be a nuisance for even longer. Now the FK-288 taking an artillery roll. You can see that I'm sort of giving them attack orders onto the units themselves, because sometimes if the FK-288 is within 1,200 meter range of a unit, it can fire the HE like accurately at range like an artillery shell, but it tracks the target. It's really, really cool. In this case, the FK-288s were generally out of range to do that, so you won't see it very often. But xylophone strike does come in. Doesn't really do too much. You can see my off-map does kill the 107mm mortar. And that is now the third artillery piece killed. Got a couple of Panzer Strikes trying to move up as well. Of course, I do want to take out this M4 at some point. Theoman's going to be forced to use those to push forwards. Yeah, just kind of trying to take care of that if I can. And meanwhile, on the right side, we are being pressed in quite hard by some infantry here. Black Panzer Brenz. They're both sitting in these orchards. The reason I have them in the orchards is to limit their line of sight versus enemy armor, but still allow them to attack the air if they come in with like an air force. So orchards are fantastic for anti-air, they really are, because it doesn't seem to affect their range above them, only on the ground. And the AT-8 does get forced to unload here after it takes a shot from the M4. M4 is going to back off though. It does manage to break line of sight. I've got a second AT-8 on the way as well. Still got the AT-8 on the left now. And due to me having dealt with a lot of this artillery, puts me in a pretty good position. And yeah, another M4 has gone. So that's both of the Phase A M4s now dealt with. We are well into Phase B now though. And I've got three AT-8s on the field, which is a really, really good place to be as the 16th Luftwaffe, because generally you're pretty hard countered by artillery. Another GMC being killed there before the infantry unloaded, which is really nice. Just trying to get rid of much of the infantry availability as I can, because then it just makes it extremely difficult for Theoman to push. But here comes a xylophone strike right onto the AT-8. Doesn't actually hit the mark though, which was fortunate for me. Just ends up pinning it down. No damage really done. And currently we're sitting on a 50-50. 296 points. Not a significant lead, really. Now these Luftwaffe fusiliers, due to being behind enemy lines, I'm just going to try and move them in here to try and get some accurate shots onto the xylophone and onto the 60mm mortar here. Just give myself some information as to where exactly these artillery pieces here are these artillery pieces are, as I do want to take them out, of course. Can see that the Ranger assaults, though, were in the edge of the tree line there, and they end up surrendering my fusiliers just as I kill them, so that was unfortunate. So I don't have that information, but still managed to take out the mortar nonetheless. I have now decided to bring in these two SFH-396s as well now, so they're going to be used to try and target both the duck and the xylophone up here, and just taking those out will make things a lot easier. Another xylophone on the left now. Going to be trying to take that out as well at some point. Yeah, these FKs, I had them bound to the control keys. Some people ask me about this quite often when I mentioned like control keys and just binding to controls. But basically, if you select a unit and you press control 1, then it will add it to group 1. Then if you press 1, you will select anything that you had selected when you press control 1. So it's a really good way to sort of group up units and have them available as soon as you need them. And it works very well for artillery because you can select each artillery unit individually whilst you're looking elsewhere on the map. So for example, I could just press 1, 2, 3, 4 right now and then just press T each time and give fire position commands onto all of the enemy artillery. So I'm going for a little bit of a push here, getting some fusiliers up, just trying to basically find out where all of this artillery is, and then I'm going to try and attack it basically with these SFH. Now the back here, I did try and bring in my Storch again for another off-map strike, but I do get absolutely ambushed by Commander's Tempests, which was unfortunate. They take a lot of damage from my AA, but unfortunately the AA just wasn't far enough back and those Tempests had flown around the right side. But as you can see, Mickeey is just continuing to be very defensive on the right side. He's brought in pack 43s. He's got the Panzer 4G there with the 3-star veterancy, and has just left me a few infantry units left at this point, as it's unlikely we're going to make too much more ground. But the main thing here is just to try and kill off enemy artillery pieces. So yep, they see the SFH going at it. I've got my Opal Blitz munitions, just unload or trying to reload these guys. The reason I moved that wasn't to stop the Luftwaffe from getting ammunition. It was more to just make sure that the Opal Blitz wasn't close to one of these artillery pieces, so that if we started to get counter batteryed and it got killed, it didn't actually kill the artillery pieces as well. So that was pretty important to do. But managed to pin down the enemy M2A1 there, and going to be looking to get that kill. Brought in two Sturt 42s, idea being that I'll use them to help with any infantry push that I tried to make. Because at the end of the day, I wasn't just going to sit here and do nothing. I was still going to try and push, regardless of how difficult it may be with the division that I have. So I was kind of setting up for that. On this right side, you can see I brought up a few infantry squads just to kind of get rid of enemy infantry in this area. But I didn't unload them in a timely fashion. Fortunately, I'm covered by Mickeey's Pack 43. But yeah, these Opal Blitz should have been unloaded soon. I've just ended up forgetting about them due to me concentrating on trying to attack these artillery pieces. But yeah, Ranger Assault, they're going to end up going down. Stur 42 is getting into position. Of course, there is the M4s here, so I've got to be a little bit careful, but there go some rifles. Xylophone firing away once again. That's going to be looking for the kill onto the 88. Does end up killing it with the last rocket. Was probably the idea to kill it in the first place, so the fact that the last rocket was the one to actually get the kill was quite amazing. Now this M2A1 getting hit. Just aiming at anyone I can see. We can see also the xylophone going down there, as I did target that when I could see it and managed to get a direct hit, which was absolutely wonderful. The Luftwaffe pioneers on the right side are just holding fire, waiting for the rifles to get in range, then they can open up with a grenade and try and take those out. Unfortunately, the M4A1 there does kind of make things difficult, but M2A1 now going down as well, and that's like 5 artillery pieces now killed, possibly more actually at this point. And yeah, taking out as much artillery as I can against the second infantry is important, because that is what will make it difficult to defend this town. So similar to other AA pieces, 88s work quite well in orchards. You can sort of dictate the range you want to engage, and then also have them attack aircraft wherever they are in the sort of vicinity. So I'm bringing up another 88. Just going to keep bringing these up throughout the game. I did adjust my division so that it had more 88s before. And a nice kill there by one of the SFHs onto the xylophone. I managed to get a direct hit once again and blow up another one. So second xylophone down, killed one of the M2A1s, killed 3 mortars. We're in a pretty good spot, that's for sure. So finally, unload this infantry. The MG's got in position here. This Luftwaffe Jäger, though, is just sitting on the road getting shot out by a Stuart 6. Rifles here, they come forwards. They're going to get absolutely ambushed. They get hit by 2 flak panzerbrands and the mortar and the Luftwaffe Pioneer machine gun. It's just absolutely crazy. 88's also moving in there now on that right side as well to kind of cover off against his M4A1. But this 88 has moved forwards. He's going to get the shot off. Gets the crew wounded there. Ends up firing at the aircraft. Therefore has to turn the gun all the way around again, start aiming at the M4. And I miss out on killing the M4 because of these aircraft, but that's okay. The Spitfire not really going to have a chance. Ends up getting shot down. 3-star 88s are quite strong. Direct hit there does the job. Poor Spitfire. Yeah, we're sitting pretty on the edge of this town. It's just, again, turned into a defense. I want to try and get some aggression going with these Sturm 42s, but it requires more infantry, so I've got that on the way. I've also brought in these 2 Stug 3Gs now. Stug 3s, though, at this point in the game, not the most decent unit, really, for pushing, since they are sort of self-propelled AT guns, and they are outclassed by things like Fireflies and other things at this point due to their 1,000 meter range. But the SFH there takes out another M2A1, but you can see the artillery is just like never ending. The airman was constantly bringing it in, but fortunately for me, due to his focus on artillery, it does mean that the game goes very slowly. And when I'm sitting in a decent defensive position here, my opponent moving slowly is nice. That's kind of what I want. Spitfire is going to come in, doesn't manage to get its bombs off. Second Spitfire, however, will do so and does bomb out the AT-8. Unfortunate, because the artillery there, I didn't really expect another artillery gun at this point. I was kind of hoping that eventually I'd get to a point where he had no artillery left. And unfortunately, that wasn't the case. So lose an AT-8 there. But I have a pack 40 in a pretty nice position to try and take out this auto car that's trying to push me. And that shows me that Spax is now taking an interest in my side of things. So we're now facing off against a second player who's showing some interest in this area. Bringing up some new command here. That's going to be providing command for the pack 40. Artillery piece comes in and kills my FK 288. Infantry, though, going to try and make a bit of a push here, especially as these Stugs are now on the way and both the Stur 42s are alive. So yeah, just trying to push out the territory a little bit more. We now add a plus one. Sora is just remaining on the defense on the left. Now has Panthers, though, so should make things easier. And Rick's holding on the far left, and Mickey's doing a decent job on the right, holding that, especially after helping me with quite a lot of his resources. But Knispel has now arrived on the front line, so that should help us make some ground. And yeah, Knispel, alongside the rest of our forces, should be able to do quite a lot of damage. It's got a really nice camo, that King Tiger. Look at that. Beautiful. Yeah, time for that little push. Stug 3 getting very aggressive here. Infantry's lining up, ready to go. Just going to be pushing into this tree line. Pushing out on the right side as well. Just trying to do my best. 17-pounder comes up on the right side. Going to be trying to attack that with the Stur 42. Kill it off. Luftwaffe Jäger end up finding this Ranger leader. Taking that out will get rid of some of the control there. One more shot from the Stur 42 should do the job. Stug 3 now taking shots at this artillery piece as well. I believe that's a mortar. And Knispel's trying to make some ground as well. Smoke is coming in from that 3-inch mortar, trying to defend itself. It's unfortunate because I think the last shot comes through just before the smoke lands. So the smoke not quite working there. But a job well done for myself. Stur 42 now going to be engaging the M4A1. Before you can find themselves hidden. So we did kill one 17-pounder on the right. The man's now coming in from that direction with more infantry. Pack 40 still in a pretty decent position, but now more 17-pounders to deal with. Stug 3 does go down. That's now the Guard's Armour player from the right side here, sending 17-pounders to help out the airman. And the second Stug 3 does go down as well. Another 17-pounder, which I think that was probably an M5 gun on that far left side. So both of the tanks that I intended to push with have now been killed. Stur 42 also ends up going down. It must have been killed by the M4A1. Unless it got hit by an artillery piece. I'm not actually sure entirely what killed that. The M10 on this side is going to be forced back. And that AT gun, it didn't actually die in the end, that 17-pounder. It's just sitting there on one health. Eventually goes down, though, to the 88. So, nice job there. Spitfire going to be coming in to try and deal with my 88. But, of course, the 88 not going to have any of that. M10 does go down. Not that it really could have done much anyway due to it being weapon jammed. Typhoon AT does come in with the rockets towards Knispel. Ends up killing off the pack 40. By accident, I guess. So, not that bad of a Typhoon AT strike in the end. Didn't really hit the mark on Knispel though. But Mickeey's going to continue to micro that. And the Firefly here is now on its way. That's the 2-star Firefly from the 7th Armored. So we've got the 7th Armored player here. We've got 17 pounders from the Guards Armored player. And of course, the Amman, who we're still up against. Panzertrek does take a shot at the M4A1, unfortunately misses its first shot. So the M4A1 just gets away with the track wheel damage, which was unfortunate, because killing that M4 would have possibly opened up the ability for me to move the Sturf 42 forwards and start hammering this infantry quite well. But the M5 gun, you can see, has come up on the left now, so that's no longer going to be the case. And my artillery is just trying to do the best it can, trying to take out enemy artillery. 4.2 inch mortar, trying to take that out. Also trying to take out the M5 gun. But with multiple players teaming up here, you can see that it's really starting to become a struggle. Gonna have to kind of fall back from this attack that I decided to make at probably the worst decision, or the worst time in this game. Like, I was like, oh, you know what? I'm not gonna sit here and just do nothing after taking all this ground. So what I'm gonna do is actually continue to push further. And then what do you know? Everyone tries to push back right at the same place. It makes sense though. If you are in like a team game and you do see one of your players is faltering, it's always better to help the player who is falling behind than try and push more yourself. And the reason for that is your reinforcements will get to the front line faster on the side where you're losing than where you are winning. And therefore, it's much easier to push back than it is when you are losing than it is to continue pushing when you are winning, in terms of having the resources you need, at least. So Knispel there going to be coming up and trying to pop that M4DD, not quite getting the job done, but now going to be moving in to try and kill the Firefly. There's a Firefly from Commander Data now. Mosquito coming in with the attack there as well. Tiny Rick takes care of that with the Focke-Wulf 190. Look at all of these tanks coming our way. Absolutely nasty, and the artillery is continuing. Takes out the 88 on the right side. Have brought up another 88 or two. Just one there. This original one on the left is still alive. But yeah, this is a Flakswilling. Should help me out with enemy infantry. Also, of course, will shoot down enemy aircraft very, very quickly. So that's another thing I'm planning to use it for. Opal Blitz munition. Looking to reload these SFHs once again. 88 now under direct fire from a Firefly. Spax has got both of his 2-star Fireflies here. And I'm unfortunate to have both of the shots of the 88 just completely miss. Really, really unfortunate. But I am going to be bringing in a HS129B3. And that's going to be looking for a couple shots onto the Fireflies if I can find them. Especially after they've just been pinned. So they're going to be panicked. Possibly showing side armor. Do manage to weapon jam one of them. Unfortunately, not quite finding a kill though, which would have been nice, especially against one of these Fireflies, which do have the 2-star veterancy inherently. Municipal doing a nice job on the right side, supported by all of my units. These MG271s did a fantastic job as well. I believe one of them took out one of the M3 autocars at some point. So yeah, these MG271s at range, really, really great defensive tools for keeping away infantry. Typhoon AT going to come in onto Knispel again, but has already killed off a 3-star M10, so not too much to worry about there. And this is when I realise that my Flakswilling is probably in a pretty shit position on the left side of the town, because I want to ideally try and defend this Königsteiger. So just going to be slowly wheeling the Flakswilling to the right side of the town instead, and putting it in this orchard where it might be able to get some better shots off. But look how many units are coming our way now. Commander Data is pushing all of his forces this direction. Spax has brought over his forces, of course. Theoman's still pushing into us as well. So, yeah. A lot of dudes coming our way. And things are going to get pretty damn scary. I've got a couple of Panzertreks over on this side. The idea being that they would just unload and be a nuisance in these tree lines, but completely forgot about those apparently. Yeah, Knispel trying to do as much work as he can. Smoke is coming down in front of him, so he can't really engage at max range. My SFHs are just trying to do their best to take out this enemy artillery. This ATA once again getting another kill. It's actually out of HE ammunition at this point. 45 shells it's fired. And also 7 of its AP shells. Pretty nuts. So Flax Relaine going to get involved with the Spitfire Mark 9. Unfortunately, the smoke there kind of stopping that engagement. But going to continue the engagement on the ground there. Infantry gets ripped to shreds by the Flax Relaine. 24 HE that has. So of course, you can chew up infantry very well. Nice job there by the Werframmen with Mickeey to take care of all of these tanks, or at least damage their morale with that rocket strike. And it's unfortunate that this 88 on the left finally goes down. So we're in a bit of a sticky spot. We're still at a plus one and we're ticking towards 1,000 points, but we have a lot of units to defend against. And you can see that Theoman's getting very aggressive with these rifle squads now, unloading them right into the buildings. And there's not really too much I can do to stop them, not in the face of all of this armor. So yeah, I'm kind of in a bit of a tough spot. Spitfire Mark 9 coming under fire once again by the Flax Relaine, hoping to get the kill there. Knispel finds one of the Fireflies. I do kill one of the 60mm mortars on the left side. Again, just trying to kill as many units as possible. Kill an M5 gun on the left. These SFHs were working overtime the entire game, just making sure they had targets the entire time. One of the U630s on the right does go down, but again, Knispel taking out the Firefly. Mickey's choice of Knispel here was really, really good. It really, really helped us out, because otherwise it would have been very, very difficult to hold against a lot of this armor as the 16th Luftwaffe into the late game. Because by now I've run out of a lot of the 88s that would be sort of a counter to all of this armor. The 4.2-inch mortar there going to end up going down. And the SFHs have done their job, but as you can see, we are losing a lot of ground in the mid here. So going to be sort of bringing up the Flak Panzer Bren. Flax Relaine, of course, helping out as well. Spitfire Mark 9 coming around for another go. Going to get hit very hard. If this was a 3-star veteran, see, I reckon it probably would have shot these down a lot easier. But that time around, we do manage to get a kill. Knispel finds a Firefly. I am bringing up a couple of Pack 40s here. The idea being that they're going to help clean up any tanks that come down the main road. My Flak Panzer Bren does get internal fragmented, but the Pack 40 kind of saves the day there. Got the Stier 42 in a pretty good position as well, and it's unlikely that the 2nd Infantry has much AT at this point on their infantry, because they'll be relying a lot on infantry, like rifles, since a lot of that elite infantry will already be dead. So here comes my infantry. But look at this, guys. You've got Spax, Theoman, Commander Data, all going hard into this town. And honestly, it's not the best place for them to push, but it was still absolutely epic at this point. Look how many infantry are coming this way. Got Spax's rifles, Spax's Desert Rats, Theoman's rifles. Got a couple of Pioneers in here though, which is okay. HS-129 trying to get a kill or two, but loses line of sight onto the tanks that matter. Pioneers just trying to find the pin onto some of these men. Managed to take out some Desert Rats there, which is nice. Hit the rifles pretty hard. Typhoon AT does manage to hit Knispel. Have brought in another Flax Relaine though, so that should help out with the AA side of things. But yeah, definitely coming under heavy fire. My Flax Relaine on the right side ends up going down. Pack 40s under fire as well. So much artillery. Non-stop. Achilles, we managed to take that out on the left side due to my Panzer Shrek. One of my Panzer Shrek ambushes actually working this game. Panzer Shreks otherwise didn't really do the job. Like, I should have had the M4 kill up here, but just didn't actually work in the end. Either way, a Pack 40 blasting that white truck to pieces, killing one of the Desert Rats before they unload. Luftwaffe Pioneer trying to hold the ground, bringing in another bunch of infantry and stuff. SFHs again found another artillery target to take care of, and that's pretty much all I'm using the SFHs for, just constantly trying to counter battery. If we actually go into the neutral perspective, We can see that Commander Data has now brought in some artillery to help out as well, but it's mostly just Theomans. And there is a 3-inch mortar here from Spax, I guess. But yeah, I tried to kill as much of this artillery as possible throughout the game, and it was just never ending. So we're getting to the point where my artillery is on the front line. That's never really a place you want to be. Flagswilling's trying to take down the Typhoon AT. Is it going to find it? No, it's not. Probably should have. Again, if it had the 3-star veterans here, it might have been quite nice. But by this point, I think I was very, very light on command units. I had brought them in for the majority of the game to just provide veterancy. You can see that's what's happening here. One of my Sto 42s does go down. Pack 40 trying to push forwards. Probably not the best idea, but more infantry is on its way. And what an absolutely just crazy end to this game it was. We are still pushing the plus one due to the left side breaking in our favour. I think Tiny Rick was making some ground at this point. And we're still sitting on the 50-50 here, even at this point. Their Flamen strike comes in from Mickeey. Lands on a lot of infantry. But Knispel still alive. Going to be looking for more kills. I was talking about on the stream at the time about a sod killing a King Tiger. So I think Commander Data may have been going for the meme here with this sod leading the charge. That would have been absolutely hilarious if that actually worked out. But Mickeey knows better. Going to be backing off. Stuart 42 there taking out the Humber Mark III. Very nice. The Luftwaffe Pioneers. I've got plenty of these left. And at this point in the game, Luftwaffe Pioneers, or any Pioneers really, are king in these engagements, because enemy infantry just doesn't really have that anti-infantry capability. So Stug 3 on the way. This ball taking shots at the rifles there. Does currently have its HE turned off, mainly because Mickey's going to be wanting to focus on killing the tanks rather than the infantry. Firefly now firing into the town from a distance. More infantry of mine on the way. Double Brumbia from Mickeey. This is actually a second King Tiger on the left from Mickeey. But we are getting very close to the end of the game here. 35 seconds left. I do unfortunately lose an infantry squad before it unloads, I think. But after the flames have died down, time to push up with the Pioneers once again. Flagswilling, however, coming under fire from more artillery. Sto 42 does go down to the infantry tanks on the right. Knispel going to be shooting the Firefly, gets the ammo storage hit. Can he find the kill before the end of the game, though? Does manage to internal fragment the Sherman. Doesn't quite find the kill. One more shot left. He just about manages to kill that Sherman, and that is the end of the game. As you can imagine, it was pretty intense to play that towards the end there. Coming under attack from so many players was just absolutely insane. And in the end, 3,975 kills to 3,465 losses. Mickeey doing a fantastic job with the 4,085 kills to 1,820 losses. His Knispel there did really, really well. That King Tiger was an absolute saviour. It probably would have crumbled a lot quicker if it wasn't there. Although I guess I could have brought in more Panzerschrecks to the town if I had to, which I think I did have quite a few left towards the end, or at least a couple. So that may have been a way to get around it. But if we jump into the kills, this first 88 I brought in did absolute work. It was there for so damn long. Killed the M4, killed the M4A1 towards the end, killed one of the 107mm mortars. Then another 88, again getting two M4 kills is absolutely fantastic. Like, these are 130 points apiece, so killing two tanks and an aircraft really pays themselves off. These SFHs, what absolute champions these were. Two M2A1 howitzers, xylophone 4.2-inch mortar, so between them they counter-batteried like six artillery pieces. And we did kill one with the 88 there, so that would be like seven artillery pieces going down. Just took three, took out a 3-inch mortar. That's eight artillery pieces. It's just like absolutely crazy how much artillery I was up against throughout this game, but did manage to counter battery quite well, which stopped Theoman from pushing effectively throughout the game. And as the 16th Luftwaffe, I was pretty chuffed with this game. I thought it went pretty well, mainly thanks to the support of Mickeey in the early game, and definitely gave me the ground that I needed to just remain on the defensive for the rest of the game. And that's why he sort of abandoned my side and just left me with the King Tiger and then went on his side to sort of defend there. But yeah, you can see like the sort of amount of units that we came up against. It was both the 2nd Infantry and the 7th Armoured in the end mainly, and then a few sort of Guards Armoured and even a 3rd Infantry unit sort of mixed in there. In terms of losses, well, I think we lost quite a lot to the Sexton in the end. It was very difficult for me to counter battery. Unfortunately, armoured artillery is a pretty hard counter to 16th Luftwaffe, as you can't really counter battery it yourself very easily. You've got to rely on the direct hits, which are very unlikely, and especially when the Sexton's firing at a very long range. So not really much I could do about that, and you can see how much damage it did manage to do in a relatively short amount of time. But that is that. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this epic game. If you want to join me for games in the future on stream, then make sure you come either Saturday or Sunday on 8 p.m. BST. And yeah, I play Steel Division. I generally play 2 games where they're public and they're open to everyone, and 2 games with my patrons. Massive thanks to my patrons, by the way. I don't really say it enough on these videos. So yeah, huge thanks to them. But either way, just before I go, if you are interested in Total War content, make sure to check out my Vulcan Total War channel, linked in the description. Also, like I mentioned at the beginning, if you want to use Sobbot to determine your games, jump on to my Discord or the SD League Discord. My Discord is linked in the description below. That's all for now. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.